this is not good. We're in trouble. That is a message I got from one of my patients with this picture. And of course, it's kind of startling and alarming to you, especially given what I do. And I looked at it and I contacted her and she said, yeah, she was going to school to drop off her child. And she noticed that downturn edge of the mouth. Not only had her child at one point said, hey, you look angry, mom, but he said, you look a little older than the other parents here. And kids are honest to that sense. But the problem is, of course, not the problem. I would say the issue that I see is that as a society, we're having kids later and later, and kids are brutally honest. Now, when I get sent a picture like this, people think it's a simple thing. Hey, just, this is a big problem. Just get rid of that little bit of fat there for me. That's all I need done. Those words I hear, I go, oh boy, okay, it's a conversation. Today, I'm going to go through things that are free, things that you can do at home, things that we do in the clinic, and a surgical option or two, just so you know. So from free to things that cost $100,000, that's what a Beverly Hills facelift would cost you. Now, understand here an important concept. We are all different. We have our own journey. Where that's one story, understand that not everyone needs it perfect. Not everyone, quote unquote, perfect. When I say perfect, what is that? There's no such thing. But not everyone wants it or needs it totally gone. Some people are happy with just a little bit of improvement and they can get that with things that are free. Some people can get a lot of improvement with these free things that I'm going to be talking about. And other people say, I just didn't get the results I expected. So there's a continuum, but there's one common denominator, and that is combinations are best. So it's not just about putting a volume filling cream here and then looking in 30, 60, 90 days or seeing if that's gone. It's not just using a home device like this one. This is a common home device, a radio frequency home device that you might use. And by the way, I'm testing these. You ask me, I'm testing the power, the ability of apoptosis, the ability of these to kill fat, and whether these can actually make a difference. But yes, if you are using a home device, it's not just a home device and a cream, maybe a little splurge in the clinic for something that I might do to help get you to the next level. Whatever your combination is, we're going through them today. But understand that concept of combinations, even in my clinic, for over the past 15 years, everything is a combination. Now, why is it just not so as simple as just get rid of that little bit of fat? It can be with some devices, depending on the extent of it, but understand a primary concern is facial nerves that come through here. You could get a asymmetric smile, a downturn of one side of the mouth, look like you had a stroke. You get the point. It's not as simple as you think. And people who get a facelift, even a new SMAS, a deep plane facelift, I know these are all confusing. Almost everyone's using vertical vectors in their facelifts as opposed to pulling back sideways that gave that wide smile, whichever one you're getting. I have a lot of patients come and say, it just didn't give me enough at the edge of the mouth. So just because you have surgery doesn't mean you don't want minimally invasive or at-home options to optimize. Now, at the end of this video, I'm going to show injections of filler and of PDO threads. I know some of you love to see the injections. Some of you don't like to see them. So what I've done with this video, I put them at the end. So when we're done here, I'll narrate you through a couple of these procedures if you want to see it being done. So stay tuned for that. And those that don't want to see the injections, you can turn off the video, you can listen to it, or you can just skip the very end of this video. I'll put it in the timeline below what I'm talking about. Number one is face exercises. We're going to alternate with a inexpensive or free one with a more expensive one until we're through these. Now don't fall off the chair if you haven't already. Yeah, Rajani talking face exercises. Yes, absolutely. Many of you get great results from face exercises. And some of you will say, well, he only wants me to do filler. He's only talking Botox. He's only talking PRF, biostimulators, only talking Sculptor, only talking filler, only talking devices, microneedling. I do it all. I provide it all. You all have an individual journey. Whatever you decide is perfect for you. It doesn't affect me. And of course, this video isn't sponsored by any one thing. It's all about your journey, what's going to work best. We do like science. In the comments below, I want to hear, do you like base exercises? But also, let's look at this study.
So here you can see a study, association of facial exercises with the appearance of aging. Okay, if you look at this, this was a pilot study to assess the association of a 20-week important facial exercise program, and they used middle-aged women. Here we have, if we look at the methods, healthy participants age 40 to 65. So we now know the age group associated with photo damage. So they had actual damage on their skin. Here's the thing, they received formal instruction on 32 different facial exercises. And how did they standardize it? Well, the participants attended a 2 live 90-minute muscle resistant facial exercise training program. They performed this, here's your time frame, performed daily 30-minute exercises for 8 weeks at home. During weeks 9 to 20, they continue to practice every other day. So there's your dose. You see, it takes a lot of work. Okay, what did they find? A 30-minute daily or alternate daily exercise program sustained over 20 weeks may modestly improve the facial appearance of selected middle-aged women. Also went on to say, rater estimates of mean participant age showed a significant monotonic decrease from age 50.8 at baseline to 49.6 at 8 weeks to 48.1 years at 20 weeks. So you can see, it seemed like the more they did it, the more results they received.
Now let's go to something more expensive, because you saw that picture that the patient sent. Well, what about filler, hyaluronic acid filler in a perfect K technique, which is what I would use. I wanted to call it the R technique for R, but it's really more of a K technique. And it's droplets of filler that's robust but flexible that does not migrate. That's what I do. Again, I'll show you those videos at the end, but understand putting droplets at the edge of the mouth and then supporting the lip. And of course, filling a little above the lip to give you lift. Not that filler lifts, but it lifts by way of a little volumization in the nasolabial area if needed, and the piriform aperture up here at the edge of the nose. So hyaluronic acid filler, it's a good solution. The area has to be done very particularly and judiciously, because filler migrates where there's movement. And I have a whole new video on filler migration and treatment. It may be up, it may be coming if you don't see it on my channel. But it can migrate. But I do like hyaluronic acid filler used correctly in the lower face, in many cases in combination. Now let's talk home devices like this one. You see, how you're supposed to use it is in upward circular fashion. You can use it in the neck. You can use it at the edge of the mouth. That's what we're talking about today. These heat up. So radio frequency heats, and at a certain temperature, you can get fat loss or skin tightening. And that's what I'm testing for you with a number of these devices, because you've asked me over the years. I finally have the resources and capacity to do that. By the way, only 30% of you guys subscribe to the channel. Please subscribe and like. It allows me to test more devices, bring you better information, and it provides me with the ability of more resources to do that for you. But home devices can work great. Now, these are slower. These aren't going to be, when I test this so far, obviously it's not reaching the temperatures I do in my clinic. These guys actually have an in-clinic device that can reach, apparently, I haven't tested it, but I've talked to them, and it's near 50 degrees. An RF microneedling injectable, RF microneedling, reaches about 67 degrees. This does not get close to that, but we know killing fat cells is depending on how long the temperature gets there. It's about 40, 42 degrees as I measure in my clinic. So these this has not reached that temperature yet. So it's very safe in terms of not losing fat and targeting skin. And it has a temperature sensor built in so that you know when you get to the right temperature. That's just one of many. I'm not saying that that's the one that you should use, giving you an idea of home devices. Here's the thing. How you use that device, how you pay attention to the temperature alert that lets you know that you've gotten to the temperature they want you at. If you go beyond that temperature, that will determine if you want get a little bit of fat loss. Now, I often want to get fat loss here in clinic. So this becomes complex, and I'll do complete videos on home devices and how to use them better if you guys want for getting results here. But many of you get great results. Feel free, of course, put in the comments below what's your favorite home device so others learn, but more coming on these. Now let's go to a little more expensive one, biostimulators. Now think about things like PRF and Easy PRF. Think about Sculptra. When I was developing the first protocols for Easy PRF, the liquid, back around 2014-15, I realized how well these worked at that time. And I came up and then trademarked Plasma Sculpt, which is my PRF protocols with Sculptra. Sculptra is a biostimulator that I talk about. It's recently been, and I did the first lecture that I'm aware of at a Congress when this was just FDA approved. In fact, when we were there, they didn't know if I could talk about it on stage. We just got approval, and that was a sponsor talk from a company. And I was able to talk about jawline tightening with Sculptra, but not injecting the jawline. It's not approved to inject the jawline, but injecting above the jawline. And that has been shown, studied, and proven to tighten the jawline. Now, when you tighten the jawline, what do? You pick up the edge of the mouth, which is what we're talking about today. So Plasma Sculpt is me combining PRF and Sculptra in specific concentrations around the face to get that lifting, pulling, tightening effect. When you think about price here, think about anywhere from $2,000 to $5,000. Typically, people do two sessions, 6 weeks apart of my clinic for $5,000. And I address the whole face, including the under eye, the temples, the whole gamut. But that gives you an idea of a little more expensive procedure. But you also get glow, and Sculptra now is FDA approved for building not just collagen, but now elastin has been shown. And that's what gives you glow, collagen and elastin. So this is proven and studied. Now, you know, I like face oils, and yes, face oils with massage, of course, can help a lot. For the lower face, we want a little bit of a filling effect. We want to get rid of wrinkles and folds. And remember, bone plays a role down here, especially females, estrogen loss, you lose bone. But the more we can hydrate, the more we can help your fat pads in your face. And there's two oils that I like best. And one, and I'll put the links below these because I now have been using from a company called Valona, and I like those oils best. Coconut oil is number one. Now, you're going to say coconut oil is a solid at room temperature. I'll put in a video at the end on oil pulling where we use coconut oil to help your dentition and your gums. That is coconut oil, but it has the long chains left in there. And what that means, it's going to be solid at room temperature. So if you fractionate it, which is a method of removing the long chains, you now have a liquid. And this one has no added chemicals. There's no fragrances added. It's 100% pure, and it is an oil. That's what we're looking for. So I love coconut oil. And if you get acne on other areas of your face, like your T-zone with coconut oil, you may, but unlikely that you're going to get acne down here. So I like coconut oil. It's a thicker one and works well at the downturn mouth. Combine it with massage or gua sha. In an oil is safflower oil. And again, Valona makes a great one with no added chemicals. It is expressed. So this isn't actually cold pressed, but I actually called the company and there's no added chemicals. It's 100% pure, no added fragrances. And this one works very well. And I think that's another great one. Should you not like coconut oil, or you find that you get a breakout or acne, but oils on the face work excellent. At the end of this video, I'll put a complete video of different oils that I use on the face and that I recommend. And again, these are under $8 as I priced them out the other day. Inflation's going like that. But as of right now, they're under $8, safe to say under $10. And again, I'll put links for these two oils below so you know exactly the ones I'm talking about and you can study them. Now we'll go to something a little more expensive, volufiline or a volufiline cream like mine. Now you're using oils. Remember, we're talking combinations. I like this cream a lot and it's a top seller, but most importantly, it's a top reorder product on my site, in my clinic. And volufiline has been studied to help the fat cells differentiate and plump. There's studies on that. I have a whole video. I'll put that at the end of this as well so you can watch it. It's a plumping ingredient. Of course, in this case, if I look at this patient's picture that we're talking about and she goes on volufiline cream, this is not going to remove this altogether. Remember I talked about we don't need to be perfect. Maybe people don't want it all gone. And remember we talked about combinations. Add gua sha, add facial massage, add a carrier, add a oil like this. And maybe add a little bit of filler or biostimulators or PRF that we talked about. So think combinations, but volufiline I like a lot in mine. Of course, I put THD ascorbate, which is a fat-soluble form of vitamin C. And I also add silica, hyaluronic acid, vitamin E, and other ingredients to help it work synergistically. But on my PRF protocols, my injections of the blood draw that I talk about, the biostimulators, I put everyone on volufiline cream. I put everyone on collagen powder and plasma restore gummies because taking things orally plays a big role. Think vitamin A, C, E, zinc, silica. Those things all help build collagen. Now let's go to something a little more expensive, PDO threads. They've gotten a lot of bad press, as you know, but here's the thing. There's all kinds of different threads on the market. When I go to congresses, there used to be 15 thread companies. We're down to two, three, four at each Congress. So the shakeout happened and people realized that they work, but you need the right type of threads. Number two, you have to be the right candidate. Now, this person I showed in the picture, yes, this will make a difference. I would tell her, hey, we're going to add a little biostimulator. We're going to add a little volufiline cream and a little, when I talk biostimulator, I'm thinking plasma sculpt. So PRF plus Sculptra. But again, it depends how much she wants this gone. So think PDO threads, and they're going to last you about a year. People repeat these every 12 to 18 months. If used in combination, as I mentioned with plasma sculpt, think about this might last you 2 years because you're supporting the tissues with multiple avenues of treatments. Now, are they painful? You'll see in the video at the end here, I use lidocaine drip as I'm going along with the syringe. So most people do not find this very painful, but you'll hear people online say, it's the most painful thing I've ever had done. Certainly, you need a great provider who does a lot of these, who takes their time with you. It's very provider dependent and thread dependent and you dependent, meaning you need to be the right candidate. Not too much sag. And this is not a facelift alternative. Okay, before we go to the injection videos, let me tell you about two more things. I have so much in my mind. Okay, one almost free one, think gua sha. Now this is ancient Chinese medicine where people often use a jade stone or other material to use upward strokes to help lymphatic drainage, build collagen, and they say it can actually help with the fat pads and the bone stimulation. I'll be going to China to learn this. If you want video right from there, I'll do it, but I'm going to be learning this and we're going to be doing more on gua sha in videos to come. And let's just hit a second, little more expensive one because you will all ask RF microneedling. Love it. I only treat the lower face with my RF microneedling because I'm removing fat here. 67 degrees Celsius temperature with needles that go in, and I'm tightening back here, but I don't want any fat loss above and I don't want any risk of that. And my device is powerful. I have many treatments for the upper face. It's the lower face where RF microneedling shines, and that's where I use it. Submentum and that downturn mouth. And in the picture of this patient, absolutely, this is part of the treatment plan. Okay, let's go to the injections here. Here I'm using Restylane Define, which is a flexible product. I'm first filling just the lower area of the nasolabial fold. Some might call it the smile line. Of course, you have to be very careful here because there's a facial artery that comes up pretty much right where we're injecting. So be careful. You could use a cannula if one wanted to. And then I'm just coming to the edge of the mouth. Now, the patient's lying down. So, of course, you're not going to see the downturn of the mouth, the RBF, or that fold. But people start to get this fold at 30, low 40s, okay? And that's what we're treating here. But you can see not only just treating the edge of the mouth with a little bit of filler, but also the mental crease, because oftentimes these go together. The chin, in effect, raises, if you will. A lot of people say the only thing that elevates as I age is it's my chin, the witch's chin, AKA. And you can see we fill there. You'll also want to fill the edge of the lip. You can see I took the opportunity here to just put a little bit of product in the lip and at the GK point where you see that little drop of blood. But particularly the edge of the lip laterally, one needs to treat. And then the droplet technique by the edge of the mouth, and that helps hold it up. So you see there, hyaluronic acid filler certainly can be used to support the lower face. Okay, now let's look at a thread lift. And yes, the patient's lying back again at about 30 degree upright angle. So you're not going to see the downturn of the mouth. Again, this starts in the 40s. Threads are going to work best in patients in their 40s that don't have a lot of loose skin. And you can see you want to keep the area clean, and that's a sterile 4x4, of course, but just advancing the thread, the patient's in no pain at all. I'm not even dripping any lidocaine in with this one. This is just a 21 gauge thread. This is a younger person, meaning 40s, but you can see you don't need the heavy lifting threads I have on this channel. If you go to my mature skin playlist, there's a older patient that I use molded large threads in dripping lidocaine in. But you just want to take your time, slowly advance here right along that line. That line is there because I can't see the fold because the patient's lying back. So I use that to keep me straight and to know that I pass through the fold. Not everyone wants to pass through the edge of the fold. To me, that's how I get the most lift. So you see how we're all going to have a different technique. You can see the patient's in no discomfort at all. I'm asking her as I'm doing it. And there was no lidocaine used at all. You see the thread there. And remember that fold that we're trying to treat? When I pull the thread, you'll clearly see that it pulls just along that track. I then set the thread, and you could put three or four more in, but imagine now adding a little bit of plasma sculpt, a little bit of filler at the edge, sending her home with skincare.